First, so now recording will be start. So this is the chapter installing updating software packages. In earlier class we discussed RPM, Red Hat package manager, or we can say that RPM package manager. This is used to install, view, uninstall any packages. So we can use this particular utility. This utility is install view install comma view uninstall and the information of about the information, not this, to check check. So we can use RPM. So this is name of the your package, this is your version, this is your release, and this is the architecture. I have discussed all of these commands. By this command we can query, by this command we can check the file name. By using the file name we can check the package name. This is your package name, and by using this particular utility we can check the detailed information about the package, and by this particular utility we can list the files installed by the packages. This package install what types of files it will store, and by using this particular utility, if we have the package name, we can check all the configuration file related to this particular package. And this is used to check the documentation, and this is used to check when we install any particular package, or we can remove any package, it will show the script related to the package. And this is used to install the package, I and E for erase. If we want to remove the package, we can use E option. So these are some commands related to RPM that I have told you earlier class. So today I will discuss about YUM, yellow dog update modifier. YUM is used to install any package. But for installing any package, before this, we should create a repository. So create a YUM first, then we can install the package. So it's a utility to install the packages. So we can install the package by using this particular command. YUM is a command. By using this particular command, we can install package, we can update the package, we can remove the package, we can get the information about the software packages, and it will resolve the dependencies automatically. It means if any package has some dependencies and we want to install that package, so YUM is used to resolve the dependencies just like that. I will show you just one example how I will check this. Have you installed Linux or not? You have downloaded the image? As I have provided you.
I have it, sir. I know.
Okay,
I have to install it.
So first install, then do the practice. If you have any doubt in practice, you can give me a message, so I will resolve. If you have any doubt in installation, you can call me. Or you can send me a message, so I will resolve.
Okay, sir. I'll call you.
Okay. So how to create YUM? I will tell you about the create YUM repository. It's called repository means it's a database. First of all, create the database for the YUM. Then you can install the package. In RPM, RPM just inbuilt utility. There is no need to configure this. But YUM, before installing any package, you should configure the YUM repository. So I will demonstrate how to configure this, how to create a YUM repository. So I will show you. Suppose we want to install a package. The package name is HTTP. It means web server. It's a package of the web server. If we want to install any package, suppose to check at this time we have a YUM repository or not. This is the command to check. This is the command repo list all. Repo list all. This is used to check we have YUM repository or not. So this command show me the message. So you can see there is no repository available because we have a fresh installation. We do this OS a fresh installation. There is no repository available. When you install fresh OS, there is no repository of YUM. But now this is my DVD of RHEL 8. This is the DVD of RHEL 8. And this is the location where all the database is mounted. All the RHEL database is mounted. Here we have all the packages related to OS. It means any types of package is available in this particular DVD. So go to this particular location. Slash run, run media, then name of the user, then this. Here, this is your DVD. We have two folders. The first one is AppStream, the second one is base. It has all the packages related to OS, operating system. And it has all the packages related to application and upstream version of the packages. We have two folders. In these two folders, we have all the packages. So now we want to install any package. We can use RPM, but RPM. For the installation of RPM, go to the location of the packages CD, AppStream, like this way. And in this, we have a folder. The folder name is packages. Here, all the packages is available. And we can install any package. Suppose YUM, not YUM, first we will demonstrate you RPM. RPM hyphen QA. We want to check the information about this package. This package is installed or not. So at this time, it will show me no message. So remove this A, then check. At this time, we have no telnet package and we want to install this. Then press I for installation, V to print the message, H for hashes. So RPM, so give the full information of this. This is my package name, full name of the package. Then we can install this. So now this package will be installed. So we can install any package by using the RPM also. But now we want to install the another package. The package name is HTTP. This. We want to install this particular package. But when we install this package, it will show me an error message. Now you can check. It will show me an error message. Because it will show me error message because we have a lot of dependencies of this particular package. And we want to install all the dependencies at a time. So RPM not support the dependencies automatically, resolve the dependencies automatically. So for this, we can use YUM functionality. So now you can check. And we want to install this particular package by using this particular utility. first install these dependencies first. After installation these dependencies, you are able to install the this package. So it's a command to resolve not resolving the dependencies automatically. It support individual commands. Install this particular package first, after then this, this and this. Then we can install this particular package. So for this we can use yum, but for yum we should create the yum repository. When we create the yum repository, we can install this by using this particular functionality. So now if we use yum install command, but now at this time it's not work because we have no repository available. There is no enabled repos. So first create the repo. Repo means database for the yum. Then we can able to install the package through this particular functionality. So now we will create yum repository. So this is my topic, how to create a yum repository. Repository means database for the yum. So we can create yum repository locally and by using the protocols like FTP. So we create the local yum repository. We create a local yum repository. We can also create by using some protocols, FTP. We can use HTTP. I will show you this later. Then first we use this particular functionality, how to create local yum repository. This is my topic. So for this we have some requirements. What types of requirements? We require DVD of RHEL, Red Hat Enterprise Linux. We have the DVD of Linux operating system. Suppose it can be of RHEL 8, it can be RHEL 7, it can be 6, it can be 5, and it can be 4 also. So these are the versions. So at this time, we learn about RHEL 8 version. Red Hat Enterprise Linux. So now we have the package, we have the CD, DVD of this. This is my DVD. And first, copy this DVD in your system locally. So you don't need is this again and again. So first, create a folder to copy this RHEL DVD. This is my folder name. Okay. So first create a folder, then run the command cp / run media. In media we have this. Then type star. All the database that contained in this particular DVD will be copied / RHEL 8 DVD. But it takes a lot of time. So we don't use this particular functionality. So first you should copy this particular DVD from this particular location to your local path. But we don't use this because it's take a lot of time. It take a minimum 5 to 6 minutes to copy the all the database. So we use only the mount command. We mount dev sr0 for the, it uses for temporary basis. And where we want to mount this RHEL 8. So all the database will be available in this particular location. All the database will be available in this particular location by using this particular command. So now you can check. So this DVD will be mounted on which location? This location. When we restart this, it will automatically mounted in this particular location. So this is just only a temporary basis. So we don't need to copy the whole DVD in this particular folder. It's for temporary basis, copy all the database in this particular location. Okay. So now this is the first command. Which command? This is your first command to copy all your DVD in your local OS, in your operating system. We can also use this particular command to perform this task. So go to the location cd /etc/yum.repos.d. This is the location where you should create the repository. So now you can check. This is the predefined repository. The extension of this particular repository is .repo.